Good morning. We need to review conservation of momentum, impulse, impact force, and when to use all of these equations.
Flippin' physics.
But first, nice dance costumes, everybody.
Dance costume day.
Bobby, what is the equation for conservation of momentum?
The sum of the initial momenta equals the sum of the final momenta, and momentum is a vector.
Please remember to write out the full equation for conservation of momentum when you use it. You are much less likely to make mistakes when you do. Billy, when can you use conservation of momentum?
When there is no friction.
That, unfortunately, is not correct.
Remember, momentum is conserved when all forces are internal to the system.
That's right. I remember that now. And we approximate that as during all collisions and explosions.
And actually, an explosion is just a collision in reverse. They're pretty much the same thing.
A collision is an explosion where time is moving backwards. That's pretty cool.
Bo, what is the equation for the force of impact?
Net force equals change in momentum over change in time, where both force and momentum are vectors.
Clearly, we use this equation when we are solving for, or are working with, the force of impact during a collision. And Billy, what is the equation for impulse?
If we multiply the force of impact equation by change in time, we get impulse equals change in momentum, which equals net force times change in time. Impulse, momentum, and force are all vectors. But often we use the average force during the collision, so substitute that instead of net force. And remember, when you have a graph of force as a function of time, impulse is the area between the curve and the time axis.
Correct, Billy. Now, it is important you realize that impulse is equal to three different things. First, impulse is equal to the change in momentum of an object during a collision. Impulse equals the average force of impact during the collision multiplied by the change in time during the collision. And if you have a force as a function of time graph, impulse is equal to the area between the curve and the time axis. Now, I want to talk about a major difference between the conservation of momentum equation and the other two equations, the force of impact equation and the impulse equation. Class, how many objects are in the conservation of momentum equation?
How many objects are in the conservation of momentum equation?
It looks like there are two objects to me, mass one and mass two.
Oh, yeah, but there could be more than two objects, right?
Exactly. There are a minimum of two objects in the equation for conservation of momentum. However, the force of impact equation and the impulse equation both only have one object in them. I often see students trying to take the masses from two different objects and put them into the force of impact and impulse equations, but you can't. Both of them only have one object in them. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you. Mm-hmm.